The Meizu M1 Note is a slim, colorful entry that stands out in a sea of similarly designed phablets. Available in different pastel hues, Meizu opted for a glossy plastic unibody design. A fingerprint magnet, yes, but it feels light and comfortable to hold. Meizu reduced the size of the bezels around the display, making the phone feel smaller than a typical phablet. The volume keys are on the left, while the dual microSIM card tray is accessible using a pin. The audio jack sits at the top, along with a power button, which is unfortunately a little hard to reach. Below the screen sits a single backlit capacitive touch key that calls up the default home screen. The micro USB port is at the bottom, flanked by a microphone and a single speaker grill. When held horizontally, make sure your palm doesn't cover the grill because that effectively blocks out all the sound when you're playing games. Powered by a mid-range 64-bit MediaTek chip, it has more than enough horsepower to ensure a smooth and lag-free Android experience. It comes with 2GB of memory and a choice of 16 or 32 gigs of storage, but no room for a memory card. The 5.5-inch Full HD screen delivered very sharp text and images. Movies looked great, especially on a display that's ideal for video consumption. This screen also comes with technologies that Meizu claims improve energy efficiency, as well as reduce reflections by up to 75%. As for cameras, you'll find a 13-megapixel rear shooter with a maximum aperture of f2.2 plus a dual-tone LED flash. At the front sits a 5-megapixel selfie camera. The photos we captured turned out sharp most of the time, but there were occasions when the autofocus function was a tad slow. In good lighting conditions, the colors were accurate, but in low-light situations, the pictures were expectedly grainy. For fast movement photos, just press and hold the shutter button to take 30 continuous shots in 3 seconds. There is no optical image stabilization, so make sure you have a steady hand. We were pleasantly surprised by the performance of the device. The MediaTek chipset ensured animations and apps were lag-free. Phone calls were clear and 4G data worked flawlessly, although the speaker didn't perform as well as we expected. The voice from the speakerphone was soft and sometimes garbled. Graphically intensive games like Rail Racing 3 performed well on the Meizu M1 Note. That's not to say it didn't struggle sometimes, as certain levels on Rayman Fiesta Run still managed to slow down the device. In terms of battery life, it delivered enough to last an entire day from 6 in the morning till just past midnight. But this was based on a relatively high usage pattern. Overall, the performance and battery life of the device more than met expectations for a mid-range smartphone and compares very well against premium handsets. When it comes to the software and user experience, Meizu's Flyme OS still takes a little getting used to. This customized version of the Android 4.4.4 KitKat operating system takes the Apple iOS approach and does away with the app drawer, placing all the available apps on the home screens. Overall, it looks very clean, and you can create your own folders on these home pages or add useful widgets. Among the notable highlights are the customizable themes and wallpapers, as well as a notification bar that includes shortcut toggles to the smartphone's main functions. The settings menu, though, is drastically different from the usual Android interface, but it comes with extras like gesture controls, which can be used to activate apps or wake the device from standby using simple swipes. A smartphone with this level of hardware would have easily cost $400 and above last year. Today, the Meizu M1 Note is available for less than $200, representing great value, but only if you like colorful plastic. Overall, the Meizu M1 Note deserves 4 stars out of 5 in our DNA test.